إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحم، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أحسن الكلام كلام الله تعالى، وخير الحديث حديث محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر أمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Before I start to talk this today's discourse, there's just a clarification I wanted to make. After I gave the title to the brother, I didn't realize we're going to act that fast, because I spoke to the brother about 11:30 they left me in Birmingham coming to. His brother? You're from Reading, isn't it? SubhanAllah. That's so your cousin. Well, he didn't come down with us. Brothers left me about 11:30. That was when I left out of the masjid. So I don't know what time they reached back to Oxford. It took us about two hours to reach Oxford. But by the I woke up in the morning. I'm sure it was after I woke up. Then I logged on into my email, and there was a poster. And I was like, SubhanAllah, how did I manage this poster already? So, but after I looked at the poster, and I thought, no, Abu Sufyan, how can you come with that title? Because the title, you've gone past that title a long time. The title was too restricted. In this day and age, it's too restricted. It's not the type, we don't do talks, be ye Muslims. We don't do that thing anymore. We've gone past that now. The days when people were a bit confused, and even some people, well, the majority, a lot of people was confused in those days, because the word Salafi wasn't something that they want to use. Because I remember once I said to a brother, the greatest ni'mah Allah has given us is that Allah has guided us to... No, one brother said, the greatest ni'mah Allah has given us is guided to Islam. I said, no. The greatest ni'mah that Allah has given to us is guidance to Salafiyah. That was a time when some brothers were confused about Salafiyah, but everybody wants to use the word Salafi in the power for themselves, not understanding what Salafi is. So I said, no, the title should have been, be ye Salafi, or be ye Muslim, be ye Salafi, be ye Sunni. Because all, you know, are true. Anyway, we're going to the talk now. So, the reason that being is that we know, those of us who have a bit of understanding, sitting with the scholars and being with the scholars for all these years, we know that Islam is not Islam except that it is Salafi, Salafiyah. And that is from, because it is something which is supported by the evidence, the clear evidence from the Kitab or from the Sunnah, the authentic Sunnah and the statement of the scholars, Ahlul Ilm. And as we know, that Islam is based upon Ilm. It's not based upon he said, she said, and them said. No, it's not based upon what Cameron wants, or it's not based upon what the United Nations wants, and not based, in fact, it's based upon what they don't want. Islam is not just speech, unity, but rather unity is something which is wajib upon Islam, and it's something that only Salafiyah can bring. I know the brothers have been coming down here for quite some while. It's my first time here for a long time. And brothers and sisters have been turning up. But I believe that, like in most cases, Shaitan has beguiled some people to believe that no, these brothers are just another sect, like any other sect. And you could be a Muslim without being Salafi. لا يمكن. Not possible that you can be not only a Muslim, because we're not required just to be Muslims. We're required to be Muslims, mu'min, muhsin. يعني every mu'min is a Muslim. Not every Muslim is a mu'min. نعم. And the higher level of muhsin, which is one arkan, having the ihsan. So every muhsin is mu'min. Not every Muslim and every mu'min is Muslim. Not every Muslim is mu'min or muhsin. Muhsin is a, like that. Huh? So when we look at it and we look at the evidence, we put the evidence a bit about in front of us. Are we honest? And there's no way, there is no alternative if we want that falah, that fawz. If we want that fawz, it can only come from being Salafi. And I'm sorry to maybe I've put somebody's nose out of place, but it's about time we wake up and we realize. A brother brought something to me last week. I was at his house, and he mentioned about a hadith that we all know. And it's a hadith that was often repeated about the 73 sect. And I'm sure we all know this hadith. And the Prophet said that the Christians divide into, no, the Jews divide into 71 sect. Kulluhum fi an-nar. And the Christians divide into 72 sect. Kulluhum fi an-nar. And my ummah will divide into 73 sect. Kulluhum fi an-nar illa wahid. So this is a hadith for the person who has a heart that fears, it's going to make him or her open their eyes and say, oh, I want the salvation. Because the Prophet gave, the Sahabas explained, asked, Ya Rasulullah, which one? كلهم في النار إلى واحد من 73. That's a lot. That's more than 90% في جهنم. يعني Muslim working like ants. Fasting every Ramadan, going to Hajj every time. Maybe some people go to Hajj every year, like some people do. Go Hajj every year. ولكن every time we come back, nothing. Nothing. Except maybe they have some anger of Allah upon them. But every year they're going. Going in all that sun, all that tab, all that tiredness. For what? La shay. Morocco, where I go a lot, morning, fajr, Badr Asr, Maghrib. In Ramadan, obviously by the Maghrib, by the Asr. They sit, they read. One thought, one voice, diligently. The Imam doesn't really want to, but he has to because he's working for Awqaf, so he has to sit and read. Yeah? But more often than not, some old men, and usually it's old men, and I'm miskin, some little kids. I try to talk to those kids, but they're going to end up being old, or they get tired. And then they'll go, leave the masjid, and they'll come back when they get old, with grey hairs. Got nothing to do. The wife don't want them in the house too much. Go to the masjid. So they go to the masjid. And it's amazing when you see these old people coming to the masjid, and you think, mashallah, this man. And then later on you find that this man is as jahil as his domestic donkey. Or more jahil. Doesn't know anything. Just do it. So they sit and they read. And the Prophet said, whoever recites Alif Lam Mim, and I don't say Alif is Alif Lam Mim is one letter, but I say Alif is one letter. Lam is a letter. Mim is a letter. They get 10 reward for each half. And here these people reading how many? I think how much they read a day? I think it's a thumun or something like that. They read a few ayats and getting nothing but Allah's anger. And these people say, how Allah is going to be angry with you for reading his book? No, Allah's not going to be angry for reading the book. Allah is going to be angry for you to oppose in the Sunnah. Because there's no one from the Sunnah who used to do that. And you are saying that you have come and you've discovered something better than Sahaba that is ibadah, which in the time of Sahaba wasn't ibadah. And we know one of the things that we accept that the action is accepted is that it's in its right place. That the Sahaba used to read, one would recite and the others would just sit and listen. Naam, the Rasulullah said, I think it was Abu Musa read. And he sat and listened to Musa, Abu Musa reading. But we don't see Sahabas gathered in one in a circle and all of them reading in one salt in the masjid. We don't see that. There's other things to do after the sun, after Fajr, before the sunset. If you sit and you make zikr in the spot that you saw, and you made zikr and so, then you get up and pray to Raqqa, you get the reward of Umrah. But in this masjid, you can't get the reward of Umrah. Because why? They sit and read, when they finish, khalas, lock up now. It stays open until they finish and then it's locked up. After, see, before sunrise, they're locked up. Subhanallah. But if it was a Salafi masjid now, you see, the Salafis are the most merciful of the people to the people. The Salafis are the most merciful of the people to the people. Don't be fooled by these people who are going killing, and all they want to do is killing, and their kind of killing is a kind of killing like it's giving them some... Now I'm not even going to say the excuse. No, it's even more than that. I'm trying to find a word, but I don't want to offend the sisters. It's like... And you have young kids here. So I said, what is he talking about? So we leave it out. But they're having some serious pleasure from doing it. Like it's become a pleasurable thing. Let's do it and then put it on television. Like people do other things and put it on television and on Facebook and so on and so forth. We will do this. This is our kicks. And we put it on television. What's... How is that? How does a Muslim become so... I mean, after we finish this. You know? When those people start praising... Even if they didn't do it, I'm not one of those who say the Muslims did it. I'm not one of those who say the Muslims didn't do it. I'm just one of those who say, we don't know. But we know that dirty hands are at work, so we're just going to leave it at that. When 9/11 happened, I mean, if you sat and saw 9/11 and you saw people jumping out windows, women and men, so maybe some of them are innocent. Maybe some of them are your fellow Muslim. Allahu Alam. We heard Muslims died there too. But to actually be proud of that? No, that is something to be proud of. That is not something to be proud of. See? But when we look at this and we find no Salafi ever been. When we had those bloodthirsties, yes, those rulers, in the so-called Arab Spring. What's spring? When we look out the window in springtime, what do we see? Beautiful signs, we see beautiful things. We see flowers coming up from the ground. Yeah? We hear the birds singing their lovely songs. Yeah? And praising Allah. We get joy in our heart. How are we going to get joy in our heart in this so-called Arab Spring that all it brings is what is fire, death and destruction? Yeah? How are we going to get excited? How could any Salafi? Yeah? A Salafi, because Salafi is supposed to have a heart that is rotab. Yeah? Humility before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How are you going to feel anything but proud from that? When our Salaf never got felt proud for the Mujrims. Whatever, Hajjaj bin Yusuf and Hajjaj bin Yusuf, many good things. But who praises Hajjaj bin Yusuf? Huh? Hajjaj bin Yusuf fought and established and fought and defended Allah's deen. He fought the Khawarij, but he killed Sahaba. And he done many other things. They say, oh, his good deeds are swimming in his evil deeds. You know, but his over deeds, his good, bad deeds, overpowered his goodness. And nobody praised Hajjaj bin Yusuf. Everybody says he's darling. So we're going to now praise this miniature Hajjaj bin Yusuf nowadays? No, Salafi will not do that. Why? Because the Salafi follows the way of the Salaf. I know some people, as I said before, I know some people might be not convinced. But my thing is not to come and give you a nice talk. There's enough brothers that does that. I want the brothers and sisters to come to a realization and then a decision. Be ye Salafi. Because Salafi is the way to salvation. As Allah says, وَمَنْ يَشَاكِكِ رَسُولًا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيْنَ الْهُدَى وَإِتَّ بِغَيْرِ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلِهِ مَتَوَلَّى وَنَصْدِهِ جَحَنَّمُ وَسَاءَ الْمَصِيرَ. And whoever contend with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it's easy. If you're not a Salafi, you're going to be contented with the Messenger of Allah ﷺ because you're going to take what the Messenger never give. And Allah has commanded you, take what the Messenger give you and leave what he left, what he didn't give you. Huh? So Allah is commanding you. So the Salafi, whoever, the one who is not a Salafi, whoever contends with the messenger, after the guidance has been conveyed to him, he heard enough or she heard enough adilla, that this is not the way of salvation. This is not the Sirat al-Mustaqim you ask Allah for. You pray instead of Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim, Sirat al-Ladina Anamta alayhim, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هذا واحد دليل another دليل another دلة to take away the salaf. لماذا? Who are those that Allah is pleased with? Who are they? Huh?
As-sahaba.
We know that, huh? We know that. Everybody's convinced with that. When we stand and we إهدنا الصراط المستقيم, we are convinced that we are asking for the way of the sahaba. Huh? The way of the siddiqin والشهداء وصالحين و ونن أخرى الأنبياء والصديقين والشهداء وصالحين. ها we asking for their way. So here's the الصحابة. And how can we not want to be Salafi? How can we not want to be Salafi now? How can we not be convinced that the way of the Salaf is the way? And the way is to be Salafi. How? What excuse have we got for ourselves? When we're standing in prayer, the first action, the most important action, and in that prayer we make the dua. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Malik yawm al-Din. In the greatest surah from the book of Allah, Surah Al-Fatiha, in that Allah has put, be ye Salafi. Yani, ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Sirat al-ladhina anamta alayhim. In the first, in the book, and the most important dua that we're going to be making. We never ask Allah, Allah didn't put, oh Allah make me rich. Oh Allah make me a good family, a good husband. Oh Allah, no. Show me the straight path. The straight path to what? The path to your ni'mah. The path to your forgiveness, the path to your success, the path to your Jannah. And Allah has made it upon one path. Sirat al-ladina, sirat. Not as-sirat, sirat al-ladina. Anamta alayhim. Allah said, وَمَنْ يُشَاكِكِ رَسُولًا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيْنَ الْهُدَى وَإِنْتَ بِغَيْرِ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. No, well, من المؤمنين؟ من المؤمنين؟ Sahaba لا شك لا ريب. The مؤمنين Sahaba, we can say that. And without fear of contradiction, we consider by any other people, Sahaba, or those who follow them. وَمَنْ يَشَاكِكِ رَسُولًا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيْنَ الْهُدَى وَإِتَّبِ غَيْرِ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And follow the way other than the way of the believers. وَنُسْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَعْ مَصِيرًا. Allah will lead them on the path they have chosen and land them in hell. Huh? الله مشروع سابقكم الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعهم بالإحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عن أولئك أنهم وهذا لهم جنات تجري من تحت أنهار خالدين فيها رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عن ذلك الفوز العظيم. So Allah is mentioned here, the first to embrace from the Muhajirun and the Ansar. Yani who? As-Sahaba. And those who followed them. Followed them in what? In Manhaj. Follow where they followed. Put their foot where they put their foot. Put their foot. Then Allah is pleased with them. Allah is pleased with the second group. Why? Because they were following the first group. So they entered, Allah entered them into them. وَسَابِقُمَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَأَنْصَارِ. That's Sahaba, Muhajirun and Ansar. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَهُمْ. And those who follow them. Then Allah is pleased with them. And of course, they are pleased with Allah. Allah pleased with that one, that two group becomes one group. Those who follow the Sahaba. Yani the first group, the Salaf or Salih. The second group, a Salafi. The Salafis. Then Allah is pleased with all of them. What we ask Allah for? صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. That's what we ask Allah for. And Allah doesn't fail in His promise. Here's Allah's promising now that Allah will be pleased with them if you follow them. Salafi. Be ye Salafi. And Allah has prepared for them Jannah. And the gardens under which rivers flow, i.e. paradise, to dwell therein forever. And that is the Fawl al-Azim. That is the Fawl al-Azim. That is the great, the supreme success. One has succeeded. And that's the only success that the success the Salafi looks for. The Salafi doesn't look for the kursi. I want a chair from this ruler because this ruler is oppressive. And I believe I can be more just than him. No, the Salafi doesn't put himself in that position. Why? Because the Salafi takes the book of Allah and the Sunnah of his Messenger. And the Prophet said, the one who seeks after a position should be his least rewarding of it. And the one who seeks for a position, yani he forces. Not that he can, but he attempts as if he's to force the hands of Allah. It's like a person plucking the tree, the fruit before it's ripe. Then what does he get? A bad taste. So when he forces the hand to get the leadership by making uprising or whatever, then what happens after he, it's a sad. Because most people who enter into that, they always end up with a sad ending. That's what history tells us. But we don't learn. Because mankind, he has a disease in him called the delusion of grandeur. It's like the Prophet said, that and coming to the hour when the earth will give out its treasure. And every 999 will feel that he's the one. Only one of them will survive from that. 999, but everyone will think, oh, I'm the one. And they'll go towards that treasure and they will all get died. Because that's the nature of man. He likes to think of himself, you know, of something higher and better than what he is, than actually humbling himself. So here, the Prophet said, وَمَنْ يَشَاكِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيْنَ الْهُدَى وَإِتَّبِ غَيْرِ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. He follows a way other than the way the believers. Yani, the believers being the Sahaba. So it stands to reason, as I said previously, you cannot be a true believer, unless you're Salafi. Doesn't matter how long your beard is, doesn't matter how big your turban is, doesn't matter how many sheikhs you have, or how many hadiths you can narrate, and how many times you've memorized as you read Quran. That iman will not enter your heart. Your iman will not enter your heart truly. Because the true love is that what the Salafi stand for. Bid'ah. He hates bid'ah. That is a condition of the Salafi. The heart of the Salafi cannot rest with bid'ah. Like the Prophet was bid'ah and shirk. And I remember when we first started this da'wah in England, we were known as the bid'ah and shirk brothers. Bid'ah, shirk and kufr. These are bid'ah, shirk and kufr brothers. These are bid'ah, shirk and kufr brothers. After that, we'll be known as other things as well, but mainly we were known as bid'ah, shirk and kufr brothers. Because everything was coming out. That's bid'ah, sister. That's bid'ah, brother. That's shirk. That's bid'ah, kufr, shirk. Because that's how it was at the time. The Muslims were so steep in bid'ah and kufr and shirk. You can't imagine. You think now it's bad? Oh, well, you should have seen it in those days. When we first rose up, because no one knew what Hadith Sahih was. No one was talking, if they knew, they were talking about it. Even the so-called graduates from Medina and the graduates from Makkah, Umm al-Qura, sitting up there in the Eiffel Towers, in the ivory towers, would teach, but just teach what the people want to hear. Give the people what they want. Yeah? Maybe just whisper in a corner, no, my daughter's not going to go there. My daughter's going to wear niqab. That's about it. That's it, guys. Boys and girls was mixing like minestrone soup. Nobody thought anything about, no. That's haram. Sisters weren't wearing no niqab, no jilbab. Forget about niqab. They weren't even wearing jilbab. You know, just the civil communities that would do, because most of the time it was mainly Pakistani sisters. There was one or two Indian sisters, but they wouldn't wear saris anyway. They would just wear that, what's it called? Not civil communists, what's the Indians wear?
Sabah.
Yeah, but they don't call it Sabah Kunis. Pakistani call it Sabah Kunis. They call it, see, I know that much, you know. I know that much, you know what I'm saying?
You know more than me.
I've been around with the Asians for quite a while, man, so I know. It's a word that can come on my tongue, but I know if I say it wrong. Huh? No, if I say it wrong, it's a swear word, so I won't even say it. So we leave it at that. Anyway, there was something similar to Sabah Kunis as well. And that would be enough. Everybody thought that was enough. You know, girls going to school, all right, you know, we can't wear Sabah Kunis. They wouldn't even wear Sabah Kunis in those days, so we'll just wear trousers. And the trousers, you know, we could just be just as disastrous as wearing a dress or a skirt. Just as disastrous. You know, like Prophet said, the time would come when women will be wearing clothes, but they'll be naked. I mean, that's the trousers, really. So that's how it was. So, Muhim. So after the path has been clearly shown to him or her, and they choose other than the path of the believer being, we hear and we obey. We hear and we obey. Then Allah will leave them in the path that they have chosen and land them in hell. And what an evil refuge. SubhanAllah. You know, when you hear these ayats and these ahadith, there's a serious threat. And I'm amazed that people still, you know, want to go and listen to Yasser Qadri and laugh. You know, let's go to an entertainment Islamic talk, and Yasser Qadri is a very good speaker, but the man's a liar. Almost came out. Well, because we have shayateen from jinn and ins. Not say Iblis, shayateen from jinn and ins. And he's a shaytan from the ins. He's one of those. The man has gone to Medina, studied in Medina, got qualified and got his title Sheikh from Medina. And even though it's still miskeen now, they still call him Sheikh. I'm sure you're not calling him Sheikh because he studied with Tony Blair. You're still riding on the fact that you studied in Medina. But now you're talking about everything that you learned in Medina has come. How is that? And yet still people who claim that they have some attachment to Islam are going to listen to this guy. And that's what makes me, I'm amazed. Are people really that stupid? Dumb? Ignorant? Don't you even know that this man is one of those ones who are calling from at the door of Jahannam? Huh? In the Prophet said he drew lines? I think this is the hadith that's going to come up next. So I said, whoever opposes the messenger after that, and the message has been conveyed to him. He was in Medina. What did he hear? Kitabullah wa sunnah to Rasulullah. Kitabullah wa sunnah. Even one time he had a munakasha with the brothers. And then he wanted to go and complain. And he went to complain to Sheikh Rahili. And in that discussion with the munakasha with the brothers, who were much more knowledgeable than him, it came down, what are you talking about? You don't even know manhaj. And he confessed to the Sheikh, I don't know manhaj. If you don't know manhaj, how can you know Islam? How can you know Islam? And it was amazing. See, this is the problem with universities. Regardless of whether it's called Islam in the university or not. This is a problem in university, because if many brothers go to Jannah Medina and they think, oh, we come up with a piece of paper, have a yakfi. No, it's not yakfi. Because we understand marifa. We have to have understanding. We have to know. It's no point we just regurgitating what we've learned. Yeah? So let me just call us say, ilm is not plenty rewire. You know, narrating. Like we said, but some people sit down and they come recite the whole Quran from Fatiha to An-Nas. And yet, they have not understood one ayah. Hatta wahid kalima from that book. But they can recite it backwards and forwards. Like you see somebody stand, they come to the masjid and they say, oh, okay, brother, let's hear you recite. There's an non-Salafi masjid, by the way. But they say, you know, recite. This brother sound nice. Put him over there. Brother, can I recite? It's like they got Mariah Carey up there and Whitney Houston and somebody else. Which sings better? Okay, we'll have Mariah Carey and you can have Whitney Houston. It's like that. That's not the book of Allah. Come, it's not, oh, the brother's going to come, and inshallah, the brother, alhamdulillah, is wearing, he has a beard, and his thobe is nice. I know that's how we would look at it first. Yeah, the brother's got a beard. Yeah, he's not playing around with his beard, alhamdulillah. Okay. And his, what's your akidah, brother? What do you say about salif? Oh, you're my salif, I'm a salif. Oh, God, ask me, won't you? We'll have you. Because we would have probably had a salif imam. I know some brothers down the road, Green Wright Street, and the, most of the pop festival ones,